Hello, in this video, I'm going to be talking about prognostic factors. What is a prognostic factor and how does it differ from a predictive factor? Before I go on, I'd love to invite you to subscribe to our channel. That way you'll get notified of new content. We're always putting out new videos, so there's always something new to watch. So what is a prognostic factor? What does it mean? A prognostic factor is a characteristic of the tumor that will tell us how that tumor will behave regardless of treatment. So I'll give you an example. The estrogen receptor is a prognostic factor. Independent of anything else, a receptor positive tumor that has the estrogen receptor will have a better prognosis than an estrogen receptor negative cancer, even if I do nothing to treat that tumor. So it's just referring to the natural history of that tumor, independent of everything else. A lot of things that we talk about as prognostic factors actually go along with other prognostic factors. So what I mean by that is, if we talk about key 67, a high key 67, which is a marker of proliferation, goes along with a grade 3 tumor. And it's been really hard to show that Ki-67 is an independent prognostic factor. Meaning if all other things are equal, does a high Ki-67 mean that person will do worse? We've been unable to separate it from grade, for example, or from estrogen receptor status. So to be an independent prognostic factor, it has to mean that that factor alone, all other things being equal, will determine the behavior of that tumor in that person's body. Other prognostic factors are grade, HER2 status, and stage. Stage, how much cancer there is in the body, is a prognostic factor. Patient characteristics like pre- or postmenopausal status, that's not a prognostic factor. And when people ask, what's my prognosis, they're not asking about prognostic factors, though the answer to that question will be determined by prognostic factors of the tumor. If any of this doesn't make sense, put a question below. We try to get back to you in 1 to 2 weeks. A predictive factor is a little bit different. It's interesting because some of the prognostic factors are also predictive factors. What a predictive factor means is that factor will predict response to a given treatment. So, for example, an estrogen receptor positive tumor. Now remember, ER, estrogen receptor status, is a prognostic factor, even if we don't give any treatment at all. It's also a predictive factor, and it will predict a response to endocrine therapy. So a predictive factor can only be elucidated once we know that that factor plays a role in how somebody will respond to treatment, or their cancer really will respond to treatment. I bet you're thinking of a couple other predictive factors. Another predictive factor is the HER2 protein or gene. So if somebody has overamplification of the gene or overexpression of the HER2 protein, and you can check out our video about HER2, means that they will respond to targeted therapy that targets the HER2 protein or receptor. So yes, HER2, if you don't do anything at all, people will have a worse prognosis, but it predicts response to treatment, which is a good thing. And actually, because we have anti-HER2 therapy now, yes, it's a prognostic factor if we do nothing, but we rarely do nothing. In other words, given everything we have to treat people, if somebody agrees to have that treatment, we know that that treatment will work in that person by reducing the risk of recurrence, or in somebody who has advanced disease, it's very likely to shrink the tumor. Now, tumor resistance is important. Not everything works forever, otherwise we'd have a cure. Tumors can develop resistance, so predictive factors are useful at the onset. They don't guarantee anything. We don't really have any guarantees. for any of our treatments, but we're always discovering new predictive factors that help us target our therapies much more closely in advanced disease and in early stage disease. I hope this is of interest. If you're interested in learning more about your prognostic markers or predictive factors, you can go to yerbba.com to get your personalized Yerbba report. How Yerbba works is it goes through all the medical records that you have once you give permission, and then it cross-references the tumor characteristics and stage and other parts of your life with the latest medical evidence and generates a personalized report about treatments you might be offered and the pros and cons of each in lay language and easy to understand, clear language. We use a lot of jargon in medicine, even when we try not to, just like you probably do in your own life. We use a lot of words that not everybody understands, but your Yerbba report is written in really easy to understand language, and it's updated. So as new things happen, you have another biopsy, your results come back, your report is updated. So I'd love to invite you to go get your personalized report. I've covered a lot. As always, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.